Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet, starring the entire Nelson family. Here's Ozzie. Here's Harriet. Here's David. Here's Rick. And also starring in tonight's episode, here's Kris.
Oh, hi, Rick. Come on in.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Rick.
Hi, Rick. Glad you could make it.
Well, it wasn't easy. What's going on, anyway?
Well, let's get the meeting started.
What's this all about?
Well, it's in the nature of an emergency.
What kind of an emergency?
Oh, you'll hear all about it at the meeting.
Come on, everyone sit down. Will the meeting please come to order?
I thought you said this was a meeting. Where are the rest of the guys?
We're all here. It's just for the guys who are going up to the cabin.
What cabin?
Quiet, Pledge. You're out of order. Let's get the meeting started.
Now, look, there's no meeting and you know it. Now, come on, what's the big message you're trying to convey to me?
Boy, are you nervous?
Okay, I'm nervous. Now, will somebody please tell me what's going on?
Well, we're just trying to get a little congenial group together to go up to the mountains for a little skiing, maybe some fishing, a little friendly game of poker.
Yeah, naturally, you're invited.
Yeah. Oh, well, thank you very much. You could ask me that on the phone.
Oh, we sort of figured that Kris might be there. We didn't want to put you on the spot.
Somehow, I have a feeling there's more to the story.
Well, there is one small detail we'd like to discuss. You see, we all decided to chip in and bring something.
Yeah, I'm bringing the poker chips.
Fred and I are bringing the food.
I'm bringing the ski wax.
Yeah, we're all bringing something.
What am I supposed to bring?
Well, as luck would have it, by the time we got to your name, there was nothing left to bring.
That's right.
Oh, but there is something I can do, isn't there?
Well, if you insist. I mean, just so you won't feel left out. We thought maybe you'd like to supply the cabin.
The cabin? Are you out of your head or something? I don't have a cabin.
No, but your in-laws do. Kris's folks.
Who told you that?
Are you kidding? The fraternity ran a dowry check on her before we okayed the marriage.
Come on, Rick, how about it? Can we get the cabin for the weekend?
But yeah, I don't know. They might be using it themselves.
Well, that's okay. They play poker, don't they?
Come on, Rick. At least you could ask.
Well, I'm not even sure I can get away.
Well, gee, we'd like to have you go along, Rick, but if you can't make it, we'll take care of everything and clean it up before we leave.
Well, that's very thoughtful.
Don't you want to go?
Well, sure I do.
Well, then what's the problem?
He's afraid to go home and ask Kris. That's the problem.
Attaboy, Rick. Come on, fellas. Let's get packed.
Now, just a second. Relax, will you? I'll let you know.
Yeah, but if we're going to go, we better get started.
Yeah, Ginger's liable to call and ask where I'm going to take her tonight, and I don't want to be here when I tell her nowhere.
Hi.
Hi.
What was the meeting all about?
Oh, well, Wally and a couple of guys are thinking about getting together and playing a little poker.
Tonight?
Well, yeah, unless you have something planned.
Well, not exactly. I just thought we might go to a show or something.
Oh.
Well, it was just an idea. We really don't have to if you'd rather play poker.
Well, yeah, if you don't mind.
I'm in kind of a hurry. I've got to drop this off over at your mom's. Whatever you want to do is okay with me.
Oh, by the way, do you happen to know whether your folks are going to use their cabin this weekend?
No, I don't think so. Why?
Well, I don't know. I just thought it might be kind of fun to go up there.
Well, yeah, it might be at that.
Do you think it'd be okay for us to use it?
Yeah, I'm sure it would be. They said any time at all. Look, I'll talk to you about it later.
Okay.
Hello? Oh, hi, Rick. How'd it go? Did you get the cabin?
Yeah, it's okay. You can start packing.
Oh, good. Okay, you guys can start packing. All right, Rick, they're all packed.
It figures.
Hi, dear.
Hi. I hope I'm not too late with this.
No, not at all. I won't need it till tomorrow. My husband invited me out to dinner tonight for a change.
Good. I got a pretty nice invitation myself.
You mean Rick's gonna take you to the movies?
And better than that, we're going to the mountains. My parents have a cabin up there, you know.
Yes, I know. You mean this was Rick's idea?
Yeah, how about that?
Well, sounds wonderful.
Yeah, and he even gave up a poker game.
Good for him.
Who's giving up a poker game?
Rick is. He and Kris are going up the mountains for the weekend.
Oh, see, sounds like you got him trained pretty good there.
Yeah, that'll be the day. Actually, this will be the first time we've gone any place alone since we got married.
Except for your honeymoon.
Yeah, but even then the hotel was crowded and we met lots of people on the beach. Anyway, it'll be fun for a change.
Yeah, there isn't even a phone up there, is there?
No, except down in the village, and that's a pretty good hike.
Sounds great. We may come up and join you.
Okay.
What are you trying to do, scare her to death?
No, actually, we'd love to have you. How about next weekend? Hi.
Hi.
Packing already?
Yeah, I thought I might as well. The sooner we get up there, the better.
Where's the other suitcase?
Well, this one will be enough.
Gosh, it's not very big.
Well, it's just for overnight.
Yeah, I suppose you're right. You better pack a heavy sweater. It might be pretty cold up there.
You sound just like my mother.
Hey, don't take those out of there. I just put them in.
What for?
Well, this one's to make your elbows soft, and this one's to make your hands soft, and that one's to make you smell good.
Are you kidding?
Of course not. Now put it back.
Hey, wait a minute. What's this?
What's it look like? And will you stop taking out everything I put in?
Well, you're putting all your stuff in here.
Well, you said there was enough room.
Well, yeah, I guess I did, didn't I?
I was just telling your mom and dad. This will be the first time we've gone away together since our honeymoon. I mean, just you and me.
Oh, yeah. You mean up to the cabin?
Well, yeah. What's the matter? Don't you feel good?
Oh, sure.
Do we have to jam everything into this little bag? Why can't we use two bags?
Yeah, I think you're right. Why don't you get the other bag? I'll be right back.
Rick?
Yeah?
I'm sure glad you decided not to play poker.
Oh, yeah.
Your dad couldn't believe it.
Oh.
Ginger, honey, be reasonable. Look, will you listen to me for a minute, please? Ginger, honey. Look, I can't argue with you anymore. Rick just came in and we're going to the mountains to play poker whether you like it or not. I know you don't like it, but that's the way it is. I mean, we're not even married yet and everybody will think I'm henpecked.
Wally.
Just a second. What's the matter?
Listen, something's come up and we're not going up to the cabin.
What do you mean?
The deal's off. We're not going.
Well, we gotta go. You heard what I just told Ginger.
Well, just tell her you're sorry. There's been a mistake. We can't go.
We can't?
No.
Ginger, honey. Ginger? Tell her what you've done. She's hung up on me.
I'm sorry, there's been a misunderstanding. Yeah, the deal's off. In fact, I almost got into a jam with Kris. Where's the other guys?
Well, they just left.
You're kidding.
No, I told them to go on ahead. We'd meet them up there later with a key.
Oh, great.
What happened anyway?
Well, somehow Kris got the idea that I was going to take her up to the cabin.
Well, that's okay. She won't be in the way. In fact, we could use a good cook.
Well, yeah, but she figures that she and I are going to be up there alone.
Well, why don't you just tell her there was a misunderstanding and the guys are on their way up there?
I guess that's the only thing I can do. Well, come on.
What do you mean, come on?
Well, come on and help me explain it to her.
Oh, no, you don't. I've already had my fight for today.
Yeah.
Where'd you disappear to? Come on, I'm all ready to go.
Just a second.
What's the matter?
There's a little something I've got to talk over with you.
Well, can't we talk about it on the way up?
No, I'm afraid not. Maybe you better sit down. This might be better over here.
What the heck are you doing?
Well, you see, the reason I was gone so long just now is I had to go over to the fraternity. I'm afraid there's been a little misunderstanding.
You mean we're not going up to the cabin?
Oh, no, we can go up there. It's just that a bunch of the guys are going to have a poker game up there.
You mean you went over to the fraternity and asked the guys to come up to the cabin with us?
Oh, no, they planned to go up there all along. See, when I first mentioned to you about the poker game and going up to the cabin, I meant the guys wanted to go up there. Well, I didn't realize you misunderstood till I came back and started packing.
You mean you weren't inviting me to go up in the first place?
No. Well, I mean, I would have if I'd have thought about it. I guess I just wasn't thinking about it.
I guess you weren't.
Gee, I'm really sorry. Look, why don't we just drive up there and tell the fellas the game's off and that we're going to use the cabin ourselves?
Are you kidding? Don't be silly. You go on up with the guys and you and I can make it some other time.
And you sure you don't mind?
Of course I mind, but there's nothing I can do about it.
Gee, I'm really sorry. But don't worry, I'll make it up to you. Wally's going to pick me up so you can have the car.
Okay.
It was a little low on gas, so I had it filled up.
Thanks.
What do you think you'll do?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I'll call Ginger and we'll go to a show or something.
Hey, what about this? Why don't we get Ginger and the rest of the girls and we'll all go up there?
Look, will you stop worrying about it? Besides, we still wouldn't be alone.
We can go for a hike or something.
You just go ahead and play poker and have fun.
You know I won't have any fun without you.
That's what I'm counting on.
I better get going.
Hey, come back here.
Oh, sorry.
You know,
his nose is sticking out.
Man, this sure is a nice place.
Yeah, it sure is.
Okay, you guys, first Jack deals.
Okay, the bedrooms are in there. A couple guys can sleep here in the living room. The kitchen's in there, Lynn.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. There's a Jack. No, it isn't. Here's one. No, it isn't. Ah, there's one. Okay, Charlie, it's your deal. Charlie? Hey, where's Charlie?
He's turning on the hot water heater.
Oh, well, then it's your deal, Bruce.
Come on, Wally. We got to get the place organized.
Well, I thought we came up here to play poker.
Well, you know, I'd like to go outside and take a look around first.
Yeah, me too.
I'd like to go fishing.
That sounds good.
Hey, Charlie, help me get some more firewood, will you?
Hey, why don't we do that later? I want to go outside while it's still daylight and have a look around. Come on, you guys.
I'll tell you what, I'll deal.
Come on, Rick, let's go.
Hey, you guys go ahead. I'll catch up with you.
Hey, Bruce, you've got an ace showing.
Save it, Wally. I'll see you later.
Oh, my mistake. Charlie, it was your ace.
Later, Wally.
Hey, Rick, you can have this ace.
No, I better start a fire.
Well, that's okay. I'll play your hand for you. Nothing for Bruce. Nothing for Charlie. Big queen for Fred. Deuce for me. Hey, Rick, possible straight.
Oh, forget it, will you? I'll play later.
Let's see. No help from Charlie. Nothing for Bruce. Possible straight for Fred. And there's a pair. Nothing for me.
Just go ahead and play poker and have fun.
Well, you know I won't have any fun without you.
That's what I'm counting on.
The funniest thing. For a minute there, I thought you were... How could I do that?
I don't know what you're talking about. Come on over, we'll play cards. Now, all the rest of the guys have folded except you and me. Are you still in?
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, too bad. Then you lose. I've got a full house and you were only bluffing.
What are we doing here anyway?
What do you mean? We're having a good time. That's what we're doing. I heard somebody laughing.
Well, that was you.
Well, can you blame me? I gotta do something to take my mind off the lousy time we're having. I thought we came up here to play poker, but you're sitting over there daydreaming.
I guess I was thinking about Kris.
She was a little upset, huh?
Yeah, but she was such a good sport about it, it kind of makes me feel guilty.
I sure wish she was up here.
Well, now that you mention it, I wish I was back in town with Ginger. At least I'd have somebody to play poker with.
Well, there's nothing really keeping you here. You could be back in town in about an hour or so.
Oh, I'd feel kind of funny. After all, I was the one that organized the whole thing.
Yeah, and you don't want to leave while you're ahead.
You think maybe we could talk the rest of the guys into going back to town?
Well, how could we do that?
Well, I don't know. We can think of something. Hey, don't do that. I've got it all stacked for the next hand.
Boy, the fire sure feels good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Hey, that's Cynthia's favorite song.
Okay.
Yeah, I kind of wish she was up here.
Say, I understand Eddie Benson's back in town.
Oh, really?
He was an old boyfriend of Linda's, wasn't he, Fred?
No, not really a boyfriend.
Well, he used to take her out once in a while, though.
Well, yeah, but it was nothing serious.
Oh, well, then I wouldn't worry. He'll probably just take her to the movies, then for a ride in his new convertible.
Oh, well, thanks a lot. I wonder what Jackie's gonna be doing tonight.
Well, she'll probably be sitting home thinking about you.
Say, she wanted you to take her to the sweetheart dance, didn't she?
Well, yeah, but that's not till next week.
Oh, is it?
Well, sure. Isn't it?
Well, yeah, I kind of thought so. Of course, I could be mistaken.
Boy, if it is this weekend, I'm in a lot of trouble.
Oh, well, what's a sweetheart dance anyway? You can take her to the hog wallow next month.
I thought you guys came up here to play poker.
Yeah, I guess we might as well.
I don't know if I want to play now or not.
Not me either.
I want to know where that guy got the money to buy a new convertible.
Who?
The guy that's taking out Fred's girl tonight.
Now, who says he's taking her out?
Oh, well, don't worry. There's plenty of other fish in the sea.
Well, come on. If we're going to play, let's get started. When are we going to eat?
Let's get the game started first.
Where are the cards?
Oh, they're right up here. I'll get them. If they start playing cards, we'll never get them out of here. Don't worry, I got an idea.
Come on, Wally, let's have the cards.
Relax, wait, I'm shuffling them. Watch this fancy shuffle.
What the heck are you doing? Don't just stand there. Get them out of the fire.
Take it easy, I'll get it.
Maybe we can blow it out.
Cut it out, Rick. You're just making it worse.
Well, I guess that's the end of the card game.
Yeah, I guess it is. Unfortunately.
What do we do now? Sit around here and stare at each other?
What do you mean? There's a lot to do up here. There's a couple of jigsaw puzzles over there. Oh, and here's an old stereopticon. If you'd like to see some pictures of the Chicago fire. Oh, here's another deck of cards.
Rick?
Old maid.
We're not gonna play poker. I'd just soon be back home with Cynthia.
Yeah, me too. Hey, we could still pick up our dates and take them to the sweetheart dance.
It's not till next week.
Maybe it is. I don't think I ought to take any chances.
Well, listen, why don't we all go?
That's okay with me.
Me too. Let's pack the stuff.
Yeah, it sounds like a good idea.
Come on, Lynn. Hey, you know something? I bet it belongs to his father.
What's that?
Eddie Benz's new convertible.
Well, did we work it or didn't we?
Yeah, we sure did.
Come on, hurry up. Let's get down there.
Hey, oh, wait a second. Why did I stay here?
Stay here? I thought you wanted to be with Kris.
Yeah, I do, up here. It doesn't make much sense for me to drive all the way home and then come back here again.
You want me to phone her and tell her to come on up?
Yeah, would you please? You can stop off someplace along the road.
Okay. You got any money?
Are you kidding? I filled the car up with gas, didn't I?
Okay, okay.
And fix a nice fire and get a little dinner together and set the table with candles and all.
Hey, that sounds great. Look, why don't I stay here and give you a hand? I'll tell Kent to phone Ginger to come up with Kris. That sounds like a good idea, doesn't it? No, I didn't think so either.
Sure made good time.
Well, yeah, I guess so. But how'd you know I was coming up?
Well, didn't Wally call and tell you to come up?
No, we just came up on our own.
We?
Well, yeah.
Hi, Rick.
Hi.
And all the girls came up here with you?
Well, not all of them. Some of them came up with Jackie. It was your idea, remember?
Yeah, but I thought you didn't want to come up here.
Yeah, but I changed my mind.
Where's Wally?
Oh, Wally and the rest of the guys went back into town.
Oh. What for?
To get dates with you girls.
Well, look, it's still early. Why don't we just go back to town?
Yeah, that's a good idea. We can all get in your car, can't we, Jackie?
Oh, sure. Well, come on then. Let's go. You sure you don't mind?
Are you kidding? We'll see you Monday.
Bye-bye.
You two behave yourselves now.
Okay, we'll try.
Bye.
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 Well, don't look now, but I think we're alone.
So I noticed. Well, it looks very romantic here, Mr. Nelson. Were you expecting someone by any chance?
I sure was. The most beautiful girl in the world.
Good. I'm glad I showed up.
So am I. Well, the heck is that?
Oh, Mom, Pop.
Hi, dear. Hi. Is everything okay?
Well, yeah, why?
Hi.
Well, Wally phoned, said he had a message for Kris, but he couldn't find her.
Gee, I must have been on my way up here.
Well, we got worried, so we thought we'd better come up.
Yeah, well, we were afraid you might be stuck up here without a car.
Well, take off your coats and have some dinner with us.
Oh, no, thanks. There's a cute little chalet just this side of the village. We'll eat there.
You mean that little hamburger joint?
Wally! Oh, hiya, Mr. and Mrs. Nelson.
What are you guys doing here?
Oh, we got back to town, heard the girls had all come up here. Hi, Kris.
Hi.
I hate to say this, but the girls have gone back home.
Yeah, but we met the boys on the road. Wasn't that lucky?
Come on, let's put the music on.
Hi.
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 Hello, Kathy.
Hi.
I'm frozen. He made me drive all the way up here with the top down.
Well, I thought you liked convertibles.
You keep saying that, and I don't know what you're talking about.
It's sure a likely story. Hey, looks like we're gonna have to reset that table. How about you, Mr. and Mrs. Nelson? Are you gonna join us for dinner?
Yeah, come on, Pop.
Oh, gee, I don't know.
Oh, my folks like me to have plenty of chaperones when I'm on a date with Ginger.
Thanks a lot.
Oh. Well, we might as well. Besides, it looks like Rick and Kris aren't gonna get any privacy anyway. And I can help with the cooking. We both can.
Well, I can't cook.
And you can do the dishes.
I can cook.
You're wrong about the sweetheart dance. It's next week.
Oh, good.
Yeah, everybody's gonna be there.
Did he say everybody?
Yeah, everybody. Would you like to make a date with me for next week?
To the sweetheart dance?
No, but I know where there's a nice little mountain cabin.
Just the two of us?
Yeah, just the two of us.
It's a date.